لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.
And here the Shaykh goes to a new topic again, and that is the great importance of the Qur'an in the life of a Muslim. Yani that the Qur'an is the ruh, the spirit, the soul, the core, the essence in the life of a believer. وَرُوحُ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَغَنَاءُ نُفُوسِهِمْ. Yani it is the ruh, the soul of their hearts and the sufficiency of their souls. The Qur'an is the ruh of the hearts and the sufficiency of the souls. Yani the Qur'an will suffice you. Yani if a person is not sufficed by anything else, they will be sufficed by the Qur'an. Rather, not only is it the provisions for the believer and the soul or the core of their hearts and the sufficiency of their souls, rather the Qur'an is the real life of the human being. لا تكون إلا بالقرآن الكريم. Yani a person doesn't have a real life except by means of the noble Qur'an. And for this reason, in more than one ayat, Allah has named the Qur'an ruh. That, yani, the real life in this world and in the hereafter, it will be in accordance with a person's hadd or his nasib, yani your portion or your share of this blessed book. Yani your share of it, ilman wa amalan wa tatbikan. Yani your share of it in terms of your knowledge of the book, your actions that are in accordance with the book, and your implementation or application of the book in your life. Yani why is Jibreel called the Ruh? It is because he is the one who has descended with the Qur'an, which is the life for the hearts of the human beings. And without this Qur'an, and without acting upon this Qur'an, the human being will live in this world عَيْشَةً بَهِيمِيَّةً, the life of animal, an animal life. لَا عَيْشَةً حَقِيقِيَّةً, they will not have real life. Without this Qur'an, people will live like animals. As we see all around us in this society, people who live like animals. Without the Qur'an, people's lives will be like animals.